欢迎我们欢迎今天特别的讲员，其实他已经去年没有来到我们中间哦，那已经两年没有来到我们中间，但是今天非常有荣幸，我们可以邀请到Chris 牧师来到我们中间。这几天在先知性的课程，也在姐妹的特会当中，其实他有很多非常精辟的一些的分享跟见解。但是我今天想稍微跟大家介绍一个点，大家比较不熟悉关于 Chris 牧师的事情。就是 Chris 牧师他非常喜欢篮球，他非常喜欢篮球，他一个礼拜打两次篮球，所以他真的非常爱篮球。很少看到那么爱篮球的人，那么常打篮球的人，还打的只有这没有 OK 好。没有啦，不能这样讲啦，就说很少碰到外国人打得没有我好这样子，好不好？啊，没有啊，没有没有没有，其实我非常的尊荣他哦，在打篮球的时候非常尊荣他，所以我们一起好不好？从位上站起来，我们一起来欢迎邀请 Chris 牧师来到我们中间，他就像我们自己的家人一样，感谢。
I don't know what he said, but it wasn't good.
我不知道他说什么，但是都是非常美好的。
I had such a beautiful translator in the women's conference.
在姐妹特会当中，我非常想念训正牧师的翻译。
So bad. Jesus, forgive him.Love your enemies.
要爱你的敌人。
Yes. Okay. Well, here we go. Well, let me give away a couple books.
我要给大家有几两本书我要送出去。
This is called Fashion to Reign.
这本叫做《天生美丽的你》。
And it's empowering women to fulfill their divine destiny.
就是帮助姐妹能够完成神在她们生命中的托付跟命定。
Maybe there's a woman here.I could give this to you.
有没有一位姐妹，我可以把这本书给她的
？That your husband's oppressing you.
你的丈夫正在压制你的，你需要这本书。
And he's come and he's with you.
然后他跟你，他刚好坐在你旁边的，有没有这样子
？I'd like to give this to you.
我就很想把这本书送给你哦。
Just come on up and get it.
你就出来，你就出来。我刚才看到有弟兄把姐妹的手放下，打她的手。
Hey, is your wife here? I could probably give this to your wife. Ben, give this to somebody. Oh, she's coming right here. This is called Destined to Win.
这本书叫做《命定赢家》。
How to embrace your God-given identity?
怎么样能够拥抱从神来的身份
？And realize your kingdom purpose.
然后明白你在基督里的那个呼召。
This particular book is interesting because I wrote this book.Out of this passion to help people find their purpose.
我写这本书非常有趣哦。我这个写这本书的动机，其实要帮助人找到他们在基督里的目的。
Everywhere you go, people are saying, you know, you have God has a plan for your life.
因为你去到任何的地方，你都跟人家都会说，哎，神对你生命有一个荣耀的计划。
How many have told people God has a plan for your life?
你有没有跟别人讲过神对你生命有一个荣耀的计划过？有没有讲过这句话
？What is it?
那到底什么计划？那计划是什么
？I don't know.
我不知道。
And after 15 years of telling people God has a plan for your life,
所以当我不断的重复跟人家讲说，对神对你生命有一个荣耀的计划，十五年之后
，I thought we should write a book on how to actually find God's plan for your life.
我就决定了，我们应该写一本书，关于怎么样找到神对人生命的计划。
So this is a really good book.
所以这是一本非常好的书。
Even if you don't like the book, that's me on the cover.
虽然你不喜欢这本书，但是至少
cut that out and frame it.
但是至少有这个我的照片在上面，你可以把它剪下来，然后呢就框起来哦。
I know how Taiwanese people like pictures, so you just
我知道台湾人很喜欢照片。
Buy the picture, put it on. Well, okay. Who would like this book?
谁想要这本书的
？Ben, why don't you find somebody to give that to? Thank you.Okay, why don't you grab a hand?
好不好？跟旁边人牵起手来。
The person next to you.
牵起旁边人的手来。
And if you want to date them, just squeeze their hand.
如果你想跟他们约会的话，就用力挤，稍微捏一下他的手。
And John will give you a discount card.
然后我们会给你一个优惠。
To do your marriage for very cheap.
然后呢，光哥会帮你们证婚。
Of course, you're taking a big risk to have John do your marriage, your wedding.
当然，勋正牧师帮你证婚，其实是一个很大的风
险。No, you didn't say it right. I know you didn't.
No, I did. I did this time. I did this time. Yes. Your discernment
John,
is off.
John, remember Ananias and Sapphira.
记得亚拿尼亚跟撒
菲拉。Okay, you let go of hands now.
你现在可以把手放下来。
Okay, I mean, this is the most exciting thing for the single people.
对单身来说，刚才牵手那一刻是今天晚上最兴奋的一刻。
Did you squeeze the hand of the person next to you?
刚有捏吗？有捏旁边你想跟他约会的人吗
？Six couples in our school have gotten married.
你知道在我们的圣经学院有六对夫妇就是因为这样的方式后来结婚的哦。
The dream is alive.
所以这个梦想是活着的。
See that? Yes. Okay, now we're going to pray.
现在我们要祷告了。
Holy Spirit,
圣灵
we pray that you would help Jonathan.
我们祷告求你帮助勋正牧师。
Lord, we just pray for the mind of Christ to come over Jonathan.
让基督的心智进到他的里面。
For him to be intelligent.
让他能够非常的聪明。
Just for 1 hour.
就是为这个接下来的一个小时很聪明。
And Lord, we bless this message tonight.
神，我们祝福今天晚上的信息。
And we pray, God, that you would just release your grace on us.
我们祷告你的恩，释放你的恩典在我们中间。
To change.
来改变。
To transform us.
来转化我们的生命。
In Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣的名祷告。Amen.
I want to talk to you about love. That love never fails.
今天我跟你们分享关于爱，爱是永不止息的。
And about 17, 18 years ago, I had an experience.
大概十七八年前，我有一个经历。
We had just moved to Bethel.
我们才刚搬到伯特利教会。
And we had sold our businesses.
我们那时候把我们的所有的生意都卖掉了。
And the business, the escrow didn't close. For you guys have escrows here?
就是当你要卖的时候呢，你通常你要卖的过程当中，那才还没有完全的结束，所以钱还没有到。
So it just took like 18 months, and the buyer did not close the escrow.
所以我们已经卖掉了，可是十八个月下来，到最后那个买家都还没有做最后的结束。
And finally, when we finally got to Bethel,
所以当我们到伯特利的时候
，the corporation that bought my business,
就是那个集团买了我这些生意的集团
，they went bankrupt instead of paying me.
所以他们后来就在那个时候破产了，所以他们没有给我任何的钱啊，没有买。
So instead of having about $250,000 to live on.
$250,000. Okay, so 那个时候应该是有$250,000应该要进到我的户头里面。
Yeah, for the next few years.
那这个钱够我们接下来几年的生活。
We ended up owing $1.8 million.
那因为他们倒闭的缘故，我们就欠债$1.8 million.
So we were at Bethel for about 1 month when the company that bought us went bankrupt.
所以我们刚加入到
and never paid us.
我们刚加入到伯特利教会一个月之后，那个买我们的集团就突然破产。
So it was a very difficult time.
所以当下是一个非常艰难的一个环境。
We lost our house.
我们失去了我们的房子。
We lost everything except for our furniture.
我们失去了所有的一切，除了我们的家具。
And it was very discouraging.
所以当下对我们来讲是非常沮丧的一个过程。
It's a little bit interesting. I'll tell you this part of the story.
所以比较有趣的是在这个故事当中的一个部分。
We went to our elders at Bethel, and we told them the story.
我们去到我们伯特利教会的长老团当中，跟他们分享我们所经历到的故事。
And we said, you know, we're going to have to go bankrupt, and we're going to go back into the business world and earn money so we can.Pay all of our bills off.
然后我们就跟他们说，因为这样的关系，所以我们也必须要破产，然后呢，回到职场，然后工作，把我们的债务还清。
And one of the elders who had been there for 50 years.
其中一位长老，他是在伯特利教会已经50年了。
He stood up and he said, "We don't leave in hard times."
然后他就站起来就说，我们不会在人最艰难的时候就离弃他的。
We are a family and we stick together.
他说我们是家人，那家人就会在艰难的环境当中仍然在一起。
And then he said to me, "Before you bankrupt, would you wait for 6 months?"
然后他就跟我说，在你宣布破产之前，你可不可以先等候6个月？
And let us pray for a miracle.
让我们祷告一个神迹可以发生。
We owed $1.8 million.
我要说我们是180万美金的债务。
And I said, I have no faith for that.
然后我就跟他说，其实我没有任何的信心，相信六个月可以改变任何事情。
And he said, would you trust our faith?
他说，那你愿不愿意信赖我们的信心呢？
And I, well, I thought, well, what's 6 months? That's fine, I'll trust you.
那我就说，反正六个月而已 ，OK， 没关系，那我就信相信一次吧。
So he prayed for us.
所以他就为我们祷告。
And about a month later,
然后一个月之后
900,000, half of it got paid, was got forgiven.
然后呢，这个一百八十万美金当中的一半，就是九十美金，就他们就豁免了，这个债务就豁免了。
And 8 months later, another 300,000 got forgiven.
然后在八个月之后呢，另外三十万又被豁免了。
And the short story is,
长话短说
that within 3 years, it was all paid off or forgiven.
在三年当中呢，要不是还完了，就是被豁免了，整个全部。
And we never did bankrupt.
我们就从来没有宣告破产。
But in the meantime, it was very difficult.
在这个过程当中是非常艰难的。
We went from owning 9 businesses.
我们之前是拥有九个公司。
And in a, living in a nice house that we built.
然后住在一个我们自己打造的一个非常好的一个房子
to living in a little apartment.
然后呢就搬到一个很小很小的一个 很小的一个 apartment 公寓。
And we promised Bill that we would volunteer the first year so we weren't getting paid.
所以我那时候告诉 Bill 牧师说，我们第一年加入到伯特利教会，其实我们是以义工的身份，所以那时候也没有收入。
And we were just praying for God to provide for us just for our meals.
所以我们那时候祷告就是神至少要供应我们每一餐。
And in the middle of that, I went to a prayer meeting, a Friday night prayer meeting.
在那个过程当中呢，有一个礼拜五的晚上，
我参加祷告会。And I walked in a little bit late.
然后我是有一点点迟到到这个祷告会的。
And the prayer meeting was already going. There's maybe 60 to 100 people in the prayer meeting.
所以祷告会已经开始了，大概有60到100个人参加。
All praying.
都在祷告。
And I walked in.
然后我走进去。
And Bill was there.
Bill 在那边。
And he handed me what I thought was an envelope.
然后他给我一个我认为是信封的东西。
So I took the envelope and I put it in my pocket and I thanked him for it.
所以我把那个信封放在我的口袋里面，我就说谢谢谢谢。
And he said, "You need to open it."
他说你需要打开啊。
And so I pulled it out of my pocket.
我就把那个信封打开。
And it was a check folded in half.
它是一个支票，然后是折起来的支票。
So I opened the check, opened the unfolded it.
所以我把那个支票折开的。
And it was a check for $3,000.
那个支票是三千块美金。
You know, that was a lot of money at the time.
对我们来讲，对我们当下来讲是很多钱。
We were completely broke.
因为我们是完全没有，我们已经穷到没有钱了。所以我就开始那边呐喊。
Someone gave me $3,000.
有人给我三千块美金啊。
Someone gave me $3,000.
有人给我三千块美金啊。
And Bill said,
Bill 说
，You better look again.
他说你要再看清楚一点。
He'd already seen the check.
他其实已经看过，他看过我的支票了。
So I opened it again.
我再打开一下。
And it was $30,000.
其实是三万块美金，就将近要一百万台币。
Somebody I didn't know.
所以我不知道的是
，gave me $30,000.
一个我不认识的人给我快要将近台币一百万。
I freaked out.
我就非常，我就吓到了。
You know, good thing we didn't live in the Old Testament.
你知道，感谢神我们没有活在旧约里面。
In the Old Testament.
在旧约里面，你知道他们会怎么做
？The prophets would rip their clothes off.
先知就会把他们的撕裂他们的衣裳了。
I'm so glad.
我很开心。
I'm a prophet in the New Testament.
我是在新约的先知。
You know, when you're 20,
当你二十岁，当你是男生的二十岁的时候
，you want to look good without your shirt on.
你渴望就是不穿衣服的时候身材是很好的。
When you're 40,
当你四十岁的时候
，you want to look good with your shirt on.
你渴望是穿上衣服是看着还 OK 的。
And when you're 60,
当你六十岁的时候。
It's a lot easier just to turn off the lights before you go to bed.
你只要反正唯一的答案就是把灯关掉就好了。
So I just freaked out.
所以当下我吓一跳。
So excited.
很兴奋。
And then I found the man. His name was Eli.
然后我就知道那个支票签这个支票送给我这个钱的人名字叫做 Eli.
The man who gave me the check. I didn't never met him before.
我从来没有，我不认识他。
And evidently his father died and gave him an inheritance.
所以这个伊莱他的父亲刚刚过世，所以他给他了一些遗产。
And he had a dream that he was to give us $30,000, so he gave us $30,000.
所以他做了一个梦，那个梦里面告诉他要把三万块美金给我们，所以他就给了。
That's why I like dreams.
这是为什么我很喜欢异梦。
I'm very attached to dreams.
我非常爱异梦。
So then we got him a really nice card.
所以我们就写了一个很棒的一个感谢卡。
Paid $3 for it.
然后花了$3买了那个感谢卡。
And we thanked him.
然后我就感谢他。
Then a really strange thing happened.
然后一个很奇怪的事发生。
That I didn't know was actually happening.
我不知道当下正在发生。
I know this is going to sound strange.
我知道这个听起来有点怪。
But I actually had no idea that what I'm about to tell you was actually happening.
但是我当下其实不知道我接下来要告诉你的东西正在发生中。
Eli would come into church.
伊莱会来到教会里。
Like he'd come in this door to the church.
他会从那个门进到教会里。
I would see him.
我会看到他。
I'd go all the way around.
我会绕过去。
And come in that door.
从另外一个门进来。
Wherever Eli was.
不管伊莱在哪里。
I would go a different direction.
我就会逃，我就会闪过他。如果看在走廊上面看到他，我就会转向另外一个方向走去。
I didn't even know I was doing it.
我真的当下不知道我正在做这样的事。
And then one day, Bill was preaching.
然后有一天 Bill 在讲道的时候
，And I was sitting in the front row.
我就坐在第一排。
I had to go to the bathroom so bad.
我真的一定很急的要上厕所。他还在讲道
，And preaching.
继续讲
，And preaching.
继续还在讲
，Like Jonathan, just preaching.
就像信不
是，lied，
就像训正牧，就像整个一样 ，OK。
And finally，
然后最后
，I got up，
然后我起来了
，and I ran to the bathroom. I'm like, I'm not gonna make it.
我跑到厕所，又怕，我怕。
And I opened the door，
然后门开的时候
，and Eli's there.
伊莱在那里。
And he didn't see me.
他没有看到我。
So I closed the door.
我就把门关起来。
The next bathroom.
我就去下一个
is a soccer field away.
你知道下一个厕所是大概要走超过一个足球场的距离。
Fast as I could go.
我就用跑得很快去到那个厕所。
And I have this thought.
我就有个想法。
There's something wrong with me.
我出了一点问题啊。
You know, there's a saying that adversity introduces a man to himself.
你要知道有一句话这样讲艰难会让一个人真实认识他自己
And I had just been introduced to myself.
我当下突然看到我自己
I went home that night.
那天晚上我回家的时候
And I could not sleep.
我睡不着
I laid in bed all night.
我整夜躺在床上
Just thinking.
然后我就在想
And thinking and thinking.
在想
Have you ever just like you get in a loop?
你有没有进入
You're just thinking And you can't come to a conclusion.
你有没有进入到一个思维的一个不断的循环的里面，就是怎么想都想不出来。
Finally, the sun was coming up.
最后我已经整夜没有办法入睡，一直在想这个东西。
I hadn't slept at all.
然后呢，就已经太阳都已经升起来了。
I had this thought.
然后我就突然有个念头。
Maybe I should pray about it.
可能我应该要做个祷告。
I get paid to pray.
因为人家付我钱就是要祷告，不是吗
？I'm a pastor.
我是个牧师嘛。
So I say to God.
所以我就跟神说。
God,
神啊
I think there's something wrong with me.
我觉得我有点问题哦。
He said, uh-huh.
他说 uh-huh.
I said, do you know what it is?
我说神，你知道是什么问题吗？
Do you know what it is? Like he's God.
你在问神这个问题，你知道是什么问题吗？
You know, it's like Adam when God comes in the garden.
就好像亚当一样，亚当的时代，当神来到伊甸园的时候。
Adam, where are you?
亚当，你在哪里？
How many know if God can't find you, you really lost?
有多少人知道，当神真的找不到你的时候，你真的是失落了。
So I said, God.
我说神啊。
Do you know what it is?
你知道到底是什么吗
？He said, uh-huh.
他说知道。
I said, Will you tell me?
我说你可以告诉我吗
？He said this to me.
他就跟我们这样讲。
Do you really want to know?
你真的想知道吗
？Do you really want to know?
你真的想知道吗？
And I thought denial is a beautiful thing.
你知道否定你的事实，否定你的现实，其实是一个蛮好的、蛮好的机制。
If I really want to know,
我当下其实不太确定，我真的想知道吗
？For several minutes.
所以我就躺在那边几分钟。
Do I really want to know? Could I take the truth?
我就在想，我可以面对这个真理吗？这个真实的现象吗
？Finally, I said I really want to know.
最后我就跟神说，我真的想知道。
And God said.Eli gave you $30,000.
他说伊莱给你了$30,000。
I know that. Thank you.
我说我知道这个我知道啊。
He said, "Well, the problem is that you don't love yourself $30,000 worth."
他说你问题是你不够爱你自己，你爱你自己的价值不及那个100万。
And you're afraid.
你害怕。
That if Eli gets to know you,
如果伊莱真的认识你
，he'll be sorry.
他会后悔。
He gave you the money.
他给你这100万。
I lay there for a long time.
我就躺在那边很久。
Because I had this sudden revelation.
我就当下有一个突然的启示。
That Eli was not the first person I avoided in my life.
伊莱不是我生命当中我第一个逃避的对象。
That I'd actually spent my entire life avoiding people that I valued.
我其实一生都在逃避那些我生命当中我真的很看重的人。
I never knew it.
我其实都不知道我在做这样的事。
Until that night.
直到那天晚上神跟我说话。
I never saw it.
我都没有看见的。
But when God said, "Do you really want to know?"
当神说你真的想知道吗？
He wasn't just talking about Eli.
他在讲的不只是伊莱。
And he opened a door that I've never been in my house.
他开了一扇门在我家里面是我从来没有进去过的。
My heart house.
就是我心里面的这个家。
And he began to show me like a movie.
他就给我看像一个电影一样。
Since I was a little boy.
当我是一个年幼的孩子的时候。
How I never let anyone get close to me.
就是我从来不允许任何人靠近我。
Because I didn't like me.
因为我其实是不喜欢我自己的。
When I got married,
当我结婚的时候
I would tell Kathy,
我会跟我的妻子 Kathy 说
for 30 years,
30年下来都这样说
we would meet somebody new.
我们会碰到一个新的人
This would be like weekly.
这是每周会发生的事情哦
And I would say, they don't like me.
我常会跟她说他们不喜欢我
She would say, how do you know they don't like you?
然后她就会问我说你怎么知道他们不喜欢你
I can discern it.
我说我可以察觉到
How many know discernment, your gift of discernment on fear?
你知道，你有多少人知道你的辨别，你的辨别的能力在恐惧中
？Is suspicion.
其实很多的都是猜忌。
What I thought was discernment was actually suspicion.
我很多认为我的察觉，我的辨别，其实不过就是我里面的在猜忌。
And see, I began to understand that the problem wasn't that Eli didn't like me. The problem is that I didn't like me.
我后来发现，问题不是伊莱不喜欢我，是从头到尾我没有喜欢过我自己。
And I like a movie that night, person after person were running through my mind of people that I said, they don't like me, they don't like me, they don't like me.
就当我在想的时候，我就像看一个电影一样，在不同的场景当中，不同的人，我都说他们不喜欢我，他们不喜欢我，他们不喜欢我。
My father drowned when I was 3 years old.
当我三岁的时候，我的父亲他就淹死了。
When you're three, you don't know what dead means.
当你三岁的时候，你不知道什么叫做死亡。
You just know your daddy didn't come home.
你只知道的是你爸爸那天没有回家。
And something happens weird in children.
你知道有一个很奇特的东西发生在孩子里面。
They have this thing they do. They blame themselves.
他们有一个东西他们会常常做的就是怪罪他们自己。
And I said I didn't know I was doing it, of course, till that night.
当然当下我在做的时候我不知道我在做这样的事，直到那一天神向我启示。
But I made up a story in my mind that my daddy didn't come home because he didn't love me.
我在我的思维的一个孩童的思维的里面，我自己的想象是这样：我爸爸没有回家是因为他不爱我。
And then my first stepfather, he was very bad alcoholic.
我第一个继父他是一个非常非常严重的酗酒的。
And when he married my mother, he said, "You're the trash that came with the treasure."
当他娶我太太，当娶我妈妈的时候，他就说你是那个拖油瓶跟着，而且是一个垃圾的拖油瓶跟着这个宝藏一起来的。
I didn't marry you.
他说我娶的没有娶你。
I married your mother.
我是娶你的母亲。
You're to be seen and not heard.
所以因此在家里面你可以出现，但是不可以说话。
And you know your mother teaches you honor.
你知道你的母亲教导，她说你的母亲教导你怎么样尊荣。
And your father teaches you love.
但是父亲教导你什么叫做爱。
And when the person who's supposed to teach you love doesn't love you,
当那个本来要教导你爱的人不爱你的时候
，you end up with scratches on your lenses.
就发现你戴上的眼镜上面都有变了颜色。
And I grew up not knowing that I didn't love myself because I had not loved myself my whole life.
那我成长过程当中，我都没有发觉我是不爱我自己的，因为我一生都不爱我自己，所以我根本就没有察觉到。
That year when I had that encounter with God,
那一年就在我有与神有这样的一个面对面的经历的时候
，I learned a lot of things about me.
我学到很多关于我自己的东西
，about you.
也学到很多关于你的东西
，and about God.
也关于神的东西。
The first thing I learned is this.
第一个我学到的东西是什么？
Jesus said, "Love your neighbor as you love yourself."
耶稣说你要爱邻舍如己。
As you love yourself.
就像是爱人要怎么样，像你爱你自己一样。
We're supposed to have a big as.
我们应该有如己。
Love your neighbor as you love yourself.
我们应该有一个很大的爱自己。
If you don't love you,
如果你不爱你，
you can't love them.
你没有办法爱他们。
You can't love people more than you love you.
你没有办法爱人超过爱你自己。
It's not possible.
是没有办法的。
Sometimes we think that we are being humble, but not liking by not liking ourselves.
有时候我们觉得，当我不喜欢我自己的时候，这是一个谦卑的一个。谦卑的一个典范。
Sometimes we think it's noble to feel bad about ourselves.
有时候我们觉得自己不够好，感觉这样子好像很敬虔、很圣洁。
We call it humility.
我们称之叫做谦卑。
It's not humility at all.
这完全不是谦卑啊。
It's actually stupidity.
这叫做愚拙、愚蠢。
It's stupid to not love you.
不爱你自己是最愚蠢的事情。
Because you didn't make you.
因为你没有创造你。
God made you.
是神创造了你。
If you made you,
如果你创造你自己，
you say,、oh, I don't really like that.
哦，我真的不喜欢这个东西。
Well, that might be humility.
那这个可能叫做谦卑。
But when God made you,
可是当神创造你，
when God made me,
当神创造我，
me not liking me,
如果我不喜欢我，
is saying to God,
是在跟神说，
you're not good at stuff.
你其实做的不好啊。
You don't make good stuff.
你创造出来的东西都不好啊。
And then secondly,
然后第二呢？
I was made in His image.
我是按着他的形象跟样式所造的。
And in His likeness.
是照着他的形象跟样式。
So I was made in the likeness of God.
所以我是按照他的样式形象造的。
It's like being an identical twin.
就好像你有一个双胞胎的兄弟。
And saying to yourself.
然后跟你自己说。
I'm ugly.
我好丑。
And your twin. Well, I must be ugly too.
那你的那个双胞胎兄弟就说，那我应该也很丑。
Because if we're identical twins,
因为如果我们两个是双胞胎兄弟，
and you're ugly,
如果你丑，
well, how can you not be insulting me?
你在说你自己丑，你就在讲我啦。
I'm saying you were made in the likeness of God.
我在说你是按照神的形象跟样式所造的。
If you say I'm bad,
当你说我不好，
you just said God's bad because you made after Him.
你也在说神不好，因为你是按照他的样式跟形象所造的。
The other things I learned over the next year.
就在接下来这一年当中，我还学到另外一个功课是什么
？I learned that when someone tries to love you more than you love you,
我学到的是当一个人爱你超过你爱你自己
，you will sabotage your relationship with them.
你会破坏你跟这个人的关系。
If you're prophetic,
如果你够先知性
，and you don't like you,
然后你不爱你自己
，you typically find prophetic negative things that you put in a folder.
通常你会把一些负面的先知性的东西放在你的
You keep a list of things.
你会把一个清单，一个负面的先知性的清单，然后你会用这个清单去攻击别人。
The more you want them to love you,
你当你更想要这个人爱你的时候
，The more you fear they'll reject you.
你也更同时间更害怕他们会拒绝你。
And the bigger case you build against them.
然后你就会其实是在你里面先拒绝他们。
And you may not say it.
你可能不会这样说。
But you think in your mind.
你自己心里面会这样想。
I don't like you.
我不喜欢你。
I don't care.
我才不在乎呢。
I don't care if you like me.
我才不在乎你喜不喜欢我。
I'm actually saying, I want you to love me so bad.
我们其实在说的是，我好想要你爱我到一个地步。
That the greatest fear I have in my life.
在我生命当中最大的恐惧是什么
？Is that I would reach out to you？
就是我要向你敞开我的心的时候
，and you would not reach back。
你不会向我敞开。
And because I cannot take the rejection，
因为我没有办法承受这个被拒绝的感觉。
I reject you first，
所以我先拒绝你。
I reject you before you reject。
在你拒绝我之前，我先拒绝你。
And I live a life of rejection，
所以我就活在这样的一个拒绝的被拒绝别人的循环里面。
I like tattoos. They're fine. Tattoos.
我喜欢纹身哦。他
I don't know if you have tattoos in Taiwan.
我不知道你台湾有没有有啊。
We have in America.
在美国有纹身。
I think they're fine.
我觉得还 OK.
But I see young men and women.
我看到很多的年轻人啊。
Tattoo their entire body.
他全身都是这些纹身。
Their face.
脸。
Their arms. Their legs.
他们手臂跟他们的脚。
What are they doing?
他们在做什么？
They are giving you a reason to reject them.
他们在给你一个理由来拒绝他们。
Because they don't want you to reject them because of what you don't see, so they create something for you to reject them for that they can handle.
他们不想要因着你看不见的东西被拒绝，而所以他们把一些你看得见的东西可以用这些理由来拒绝他。这些理由呢，对他们来讲都比较好过。
It's actually a big old sign that says, "I'm starving for attention."
其实是在他们在表达的是什么？我很需要人注意我。
But when I try to give it to you,
可是当我尝试要给你的时候
，you reject me.
你会拒绝我
，because you're afraid.
因为你害怕。
But if you got to know me,
如果你真的认识我
，you wouldn't like me.
你不会喜欢我的。
I know this doesn't work in Taiwanese or in Mandarin, but in English, there's a word intimacy.
你知道在英文有一个词叫做亲密 intimacy
and Danny Silk says intimacy means into me you see
那 Danny Silk 牧师常会这样讲 intimacy 就是亲密是什么 into me 就是我把我自己敞开让你可以看
and I watch this thing happen with young people
我看到年轻人他们就会在这个当中挣扎
I've been 20 years leading the school ministry And God and I agree.
然后神跟我都同意这个件事情。
About sex is very good.
就是性是非常美好的。
I watch this thing happen.
我就这样看的。
Because I've been there long enough to watch some people been there 15 years, 10 years, 12 years.
所以我看见在这些年间当中，不管是十年，或者是十二年，或者是十五年。
I see people. They say, you know, there's this. Let me say, there's 2,500 students in our school right now.
你知道现在在我们的圣经学院有2500个学生正在上课。
Probably 2,000 of them are single.
大概有2000个学生是单身的。
Men and women from all over the world.
他们是来自于世界不同国家的这些的弟兄姐妹聚集在这个地方上课。
Beautiful women.
是非常美丽的姐妹们。
Amazing men.
非常棒的弟兄们。
Godly.
非常爱主敬虔的。
They came to seek God.
他们来这里来寻求神的面。
And I watch this pattern.
我就看到一个模式不断的发生。
The lady, she dates someone.
然后这个姐妹就在上课的过程当中，她跟一个人交往。
And then you know, or they say.
然后他们会说
，I can't find anybody.
我找不到任何人呐。
I can't find anybody.
我找不到任何人。
You can't find anybody.
什么叫做你找不到任何人
？This is like fishing at the fish hatchery.
这就你就是好像去在那个鱼的养殖场那边去钓鱼一样，怎么会找不到鱼？
Just choose somebody.
就随便选嘛。
Right here.
就在这里。
And sometimes I have all the single people stand up.
有的时候我就叫单身的从位上站起来，没有对象的站起来。
Say, all right, men.
我说弟兄们。
These are the women.
看到这些都是姐妹，单身的姐妹们。
Get married.
结婚吧。
Let's do this right now.
我们现在就把这个事情搞定。
And I watch this pattern.
我就看到这个模式不断发生了。
The young beautiful woman is example.
啊，举个例子，就是一个非常美丽的一个姐妹。
She's been with us 10 years.
她已经跟我可能在我们的教会已经十年了。
She can't find anybody.
可是她找不到任何的弟兄。
There's 7.4 billion people on the planet.
在地球上有78亿的人口。
7.4 billion people.
78亿的人口。
There are more people alive right now on the planet.
在现在活着的人哦，有。
Than alive in all of history,
比全人类历史当中的人类都还要多。
And you can talk to 6 billion of them.
你可以跟60亿的人说话。
On the internet,
在网络上面跟他们说话。
I can't find anybody.
我找不到任何人。
You can't find anybody.
找不到任何人。
What are you freaking blind?
你是瞎眼哦。
I just want to just slap him.
我就很想给他一个耳光啊。
Open your eyes.
打开眼睛吧。
You know how Jesus how he spit on him?
你知道耶稣不是要医治眼瞎的人，然后就吐个唾沫。
And his eyes were open.
眼睛就打开了吗
？I can't find anybody.
找不到任何人。
How about now?
现在看得到吧？找到了吗
？All clear up for you.
现在清晰了一点吗
And I watch these. This is men and women. They're both.
弟兄跟姐妹都一样啊。
And we'll just call her Jane.
假设这个姐妹是 Jane.
I see. I watch. She gets a date.
好 ，Jane， 比如说她去约会，
晚上
她跟这个弟兄在一起。
Three months.
三个月。
Four months.
四个月。
How are you doing?
你怎么了？
He's so amazing.
他好棒哦。
I'm like, all right, Jane's got it finally.
Oh, Jane,
she got one on the line.
他已经抓钓到一只了。
Six months.
六个月。
Seven months.
七个月。
Pretty soon, how are you doing?
后来怎么了？
I just don't know.
我不确定
耶。He's the one.
他是不是那一位？
You know, he's got this thing.
他有这个东西。
I just don't know.
我不太确定耶。
And pretty soon,
很快的。
He gets off the hook and swims away.
然后就分手了，那个鱼又游走了。
And then 6 months later, she gets another one.
六个月之后，他又钓到一条。
I got another one.
又钓了一条。
Oh, how are you doing?
好不好？
Oh, he's so...
太棒了。
So amazing.
好棒哦，棒棒。
6 months.
六个月之后。
7 months.
第七个月。
How are you doing?
怎么了？
I just don't know if he's the one.
不知道他是不是那一位。
I don't know. He's got some problems.
有些状况啊。
Issues.
他有一些问题啊。
He's got some issues.
他有一些问题啊。
And I watch this.
我就看这样的。
I'm not talking about sex now.
我现在讲的不是性关系哦。
But I watch these people.
我看这两个人。
They start dating.
开始交往。
And when they get closer and closer.
当他们越来越靠近。
When they begin to get intimate.
刚开始越来越。
Not sex.
我不讲性关系哦。
Intimacy.
我讲的是讲的是亲密感。
Jane fears.
突然 Jane 会感到恐惧。
That Joe.
他感觉。
Is going to see in her.
他怕 Joe 会看到他生命里面。
What she thinks she sees in her.
他怕就看见他生命里面他自己认为有的这个东西。
And she begins to build a case against Joe.
所以他就自己。
Joe's not perfect.
他就自己先捏造一些旧的问题。哎呀，旧他有问题，他有些东西不完美不好。
See, love covers a multitude of sins.
你要知道，爱可以遮掩一切的过犯。
But fear makes things up that aren't even there.
然后恐惧会让一些根本就不存在的东西感觉好像是很呆鸡大屌一样。
And Jane does this for 10 years.
所以 Jane 就在十年当中不断重复这个循环，
10 years.
循环，他不断的在这样的一个东西当中。
And finally, I say to Jane.
最后我就跟 Jane 说
，Jane, the problem.
Jane 那个问题哦
，isn't that men have flaws?
不是因为男人有瑕疵。
The problem is.
问题是
that you haven't come to grips with yours.
你没有先面对到你自己。
And you don't love you.
你不爱自己、啊。
Because you're not perfect.
因为你不完美。
And you have to realize
你必须要明白
that Jesus loves you just as you are.
耶稣照着你的本相接纳你
And where you're weak, He is strong.
在你软弱的地方，他是刚强的。
Jesus wants us to love.
耶稣渴望我们来爱
ourselves.
爱我们自己。
He in John chapter something.
在约翰福音其中一章里面。
Shut up. In Luke chapter 6,
在路加福音，在路加福音第六章。
See, man, you're messing up my message.
I didn't.
I reject you. Give me the other translator. Where is she? I love the other translator. I love her.
Intimacy.
These pop up. Get out of here. So weird. I know how you can make your church grow.
我知道怎么样让你教会增长。
Get rid of him. In John 13.
福音十三章
Jesus said, I give you a new commandment.
耶稣说我给你们一个新的命令
That you love one another.
你们要彼此相爱
As I love you.
就像我爱你们一样
The old covenant said, love your neighbor as you love yourself.
旧约是说你要爱人如己
Jesus said, I got a new commandment for you.
耶稣说我有一个新的命令
I want you to love you like I love you.
他说：“你要爱你，像我爱你一样。”
And I want you to love your enemies.
然后我要你爱你的敌人。
The way I love you.
也像我爱你一样。
Under the old covenant,
在旧约里面
I love my neighbor as I love me.
我爱我的邻舍如同爱我自己一样。
Now I love my neighbor the way he loves me.
现在我要爱我的邻舍，照着他爱我的方式爱他。
And now I don't just love my neighbor.
而且现在我不只是要爱我的邻舍哦。
Now I love my enemies.
还要爱我的敌人。
Now I go from me learning to love me.
现在我从学习怎么样爱我自己。
To me learning to him letting him love me.
然后让我学习让他来爱我。
How many know that's a whole other level of love?
有多少人知道这个爱的层次是完全不一样的
？I mean, he doesn't love me.
他不是爱我而已哦。
He like loves me.
他是非常的爱我。
Like I'm his favorite.
就是我是他最爱的那一位。
You didn't know that, huh?
你其实不知道，对不对
？You were his second favorite.
你是他第二个爱的。
You were number like 6 or 7. Way down the list there somewhere. So Jesus commands us
love your enemy.
To love. Am I preaching or are you preaching? Because you paid me a lot of money to come here and clean up what you've been doing for a year. So now we're supposed to love not just our neighbor.
所以我们现在不只是要爱我们的邻舍
，We're supposed to love our enemies，
也要爱我们的敌人。
See the thing about loving most your neighbors，
你知道爱你的邻舍是什么样的一个爱法
？Is that you're being reciprocal？
爱你的邻舍就是一个
like, ，They love you，
啊，礼尚往来的一种爱。
You love them back，
你他爱你，你把这个爱还给他。
They give you something， he said， Okay， I love you，
你就说，哎，我爱你。
Okay， you love me back，
我爱你。
I you gave me something to love you with。
你给我一个东西，让我可以把这个东西再还给你。
But enemies,
那敌人是什
么 ？Don't love you.
他不爱你啊。
When you love someone who doesn't love you,
当你爱一个完全不爱你的人
，you prove that you have a source.
你就证明了你有另外一个爱的源头。
That doesn't have to be reciprocal.
那个爱的源头不是一个礼尚往来的爱。
Aren't you understanding what I said?
你明白我在说什么吗
？When I love you,
当我爱你的时候
，without you loving me.
可是不需要你爱我。
I just proved that I have a source that's coming from somewhere else.
我就证明了我有一个爱的源头是从另外一个地方来的，不是从你
来的。Now Jesus said,
所以耶稣说
，I don't want you just to love him like you love you.
我不要你只是爱他像你爱你自己一样。
I want you to love him.
我想要你爱他
like I love you.
像我爱你一样。
I'm like, okay, here's another level.
啊，所以呢，现在是一个另外一个爱的层次了。
Years ago, we owned a repair shop.
几年前，其实我们有一个这个就是修车厂。
And the very first month I bought the repair shop,
我前几个月买下这个修车厂的时候
the Forest Service brought in a truck.
然后那个福特的公司他们就带来一个卡车
And they had 8 tires to put on it.
然后就有8个轮胎要可以放在这个卡车上面
And I had the tires there.
然后我有这些轮胎
And the next morning someone stole them.
啊，隔一天早上有人把这个轮胎偷走了。
Now, remember, we lived in a very small town of 3,000 people.
你要知道，我们住的那个乡镇只有3000个居民而已。
So I ended up having to go buy all brand new tires for the Forest Service.
啊，所以我后来必须要再去买全新的轮胎。
Because I didn't have any insurance for the tires.
啊，因为我那时候已经被偷走了，我也没有任何的保险。
And about a month later,
一个月之后
，I got a phone call from the sheriff.
然后那个警察长打电话给我
，And he said, I think we may have found your tires.
他说我们可能找到你的轮胎了。
And so we went down to the store, and there was the tires.
所以我们就去到那个商店，哎，我的轮胎在那里。
In Cran, they said U.S. Forest Service. You know Cran, you know writing on the sides.
Okay, 上面，然后他就用那粉笔写东西在上面。
Right on the side of the tire.
写的 what is it?
You know a crayon. You know what crayons are.
Yeah.
Well, they wrote it on the side of the tire, the name of the company.
Oh, so they 就把那个公司的名字用粉笔写在上面。
On all 8 tires.
在这八个轮子上面。
So
轮胎上面。
They arrested the guy.
他们就把这个人抓起来。
And put him in jail.
就把他关在监牢里面。
He didn't know the guy who got arrested. He didn't know that I knew he stole the tires.
所以这个被关在监牢里面的人不知道，我已经知道他偷我的轮胎。
A year later,
一年之后
，he brings his truck. The guy who stole my tires brings his truck in to get it fixed.
所以呢，一年之后，这个偷我轮胎的人把他的卡车来到我的修车厂要修车。
And my partner says, "Hey, that's the guy who stole our tires."
那我的一个工作伙伴说，哎，就是那个家伙偷了我们的轮胎。
I said, I'm going to get this guy.
我说我要好好的修理他。
So I bring his truck in.
我就把他的卡车带进来。
And I start tearing the motor into little pieces.
我就把他整个的引擎整个拆掉。
And I'm going to wait till he comes.
我要等他来的时候。
And give him his motor.
把这个拆掉的引擎还给他。
In a box.
再放在一个箱，放在一个纸箱里面还给他。
And thank him for stealing my tires.
然后感谢他偷我的轮胎。
So I'm in there.
我就在那边坐。
Tearing his motor all apart.
把他整个的引擎拆掉。
And one of the guys who's a Christian.
其中另外一个我公另外一个同那个同事他是基督徒。
I'm sitting in the hood.
我就坐在那边在坐。
With this big truck.
这是一个很大很大的卡车。
Sitting in the hood and I'm tearing all things out.
我把这东西全部拆开。
And he says.
他说。
What are you doing?
你在干嘛？
I thought the guy came in because he had a bad carburetor.
我说他以为来这个东西，因为他这个东西这个功能坏掉了。
I said this guy stole my tires.
我说这个人偷我的轮胎。
I'm going to give him his truck back in little pieces.
我要把他整个卡车一块一块的还给他。
And he looks at me.
他看着我。
And he said, "What would Jesus do?"
他说耶稣会怎么做
？Wrecked a perfectly good bitterness.
你看我的当下的这个苦读完全被他搞砸了。
What would Jesus do?
他说耶稣会怎么做？
And he walked off.
然后就走掉
了。I'm sitting there.
我就坐在那边。
What would Jesus do?
耶稣会怎么做？
What would Jesus do?
耶稣会怎么做？
What would Jesus do?
耶稣会怎么做呢？
And I'm thinking Jesus.
我就想说耶稣。
He wasn't a mechanic.
耶稣不是一个修车的。
He was a carpenter.
他是个木匠。
I don't have to worry about it.
我不需要担心耶稣会怎么做，他不会做车子。
I'm thinking, what would Jesus do?
我就想耶稣会怎么做
？Oh no! So I put the motor all back together.
我就把那个引擎重新组回去。
I fixed his truck. What he brought it in for?
我就把他本来要修理的东西修好了。
And that night he came in to pick his truck up.
那一天他来要把他车开走的时候。
And I said to him,
我就跟他说
，Hi, I'm Chris.
我说我是 Chris.
Worked on your truck.
我今天就帮你修车。
A year ago, you stole my tires.
一年前你偷了我的轮胎。
Oh no, it wasn't me.
哦，没有没有，不是我，不是我，不是我。
No, no, I know it was you.
我知道是你。
No,
wait.
I said, whoa, back up the train. Hang on.
我说你不用担心，不用担心。
And Jesus told me.
今天耶稣告诉我。
To let you know.
让你知道。
That he loves you.
他很爱你。
So he told me that I was to fix your truck for free.
他说要我修你的车是免费的修。
Because he forgives you.
因为他赦免你的。
He goes.
他说。
Okay.
好。
I walk out of the office.
当我从办公室走。
He's in there for 5 minutes staring at the wall.
我走从我的办公室里面走出来，他还坐在我办公室里面五分钟，就在看着墙壁。
And he keeps going.
Okay. Okay.
There is nobody in there.
没有人在里面，他在 okay.
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 He gets in his truck.
他上他的卡车。
Like 10 minutes later.
十分钟之后他出来上面。
It's in the bay still in the shop.
他还是在我的那个修车厂里。
And he's sitting there.
他坐在那里。
Hands on the steering wheel.
他手放在
方向盘上。
看着墙壁。
Okay.
Okay.
It was so fun.
真的看他这样子真的很开心。
It was much better.
这个比之前要整他更好。
Giving him his motor in pieces.
把他的那个引擎拆掉，这个比拆掉引擎更好。
You know, we teach people how to treat us.
你知道我们教导别人怎么样对待我们。
By the way we treat ourselves.
透过我们怎么样对待我们自己。
We teach people how to treat us.
我们教导别人怎么样对待我们。
You know, if let's just pretend that you know you have a whole house.
假设你有一个房子。
And that you are a pig.
然后你就像是猪一样的生活。
Junk everywhere. Junk in the front yard.
前院垃圾。
Windows are all broken.
然后玻璃都破了，窗户的玻璃都破了。
And you invite me over your house.
然后你邀请我去你家里。
I may not put my feet up on the my coffee table
可能在我的家里面我不会把我的脚放在我的茶几上
but I bet I will on yours
在你家的茶几我一定会放上去
you know why
你知道为什么
you just told me how to treat you
你教导我怎么样对待你
by the way you treat you
你怎么样对待你自己我就会怎么样对待你
you come over my house
你来到我家里
and I might not live in a beautiful house
我可能不是住在一个非常美的家
but you know the yard's kept nice and everything's nice and clean
前院都是修理的干干净净的所有东西都干干净净整整齐齐的
you may put your feet up on your coffee table
你可能在你家里面会把脚放在茶几上
but I bet you don't on mine
可是你在我家里面绝对不会这样做
you know why
你知道为什么
I taught you how to treat me
因为我教导你怎么样对待我
by the way I treat me
透过我怎么样对待我自己
when people say
当有人说
nobody respects me
没有人尊重我
well there are always some people who won't respect you
知道是没有错有一些的人就是不会尊重你
But if nobody respects you,
可是如果都没有人尊重你，
it's because you don't respect you.
原因是因为你从来都不尊重你自己。
You know, there will always be people who don't like you.
总是会有些的人不喜欢你。
As we said earlier,
就像我们之前所说的，
we're supposed to love our enemies.
我们要爱我们的敌人。
That means we should have some enemies.
意思是说，我们人生一定会有一些的敌人的。
And by the way, if you don't have any enemies,
如果你人生当中没有任何的敌人，
you're not doing anything to resist.
你没有在做任何东西是仇敌需要抵挡的。
You're not living a life worth being resisted.
你没有在活出一个人生是值得仇敌抵挡的。
So you always have some people who don't like you, don't matter what you do.
不管你怎么，不管你做什么，总是会有一些人不喜欢你。
But if you say nobody likes me,
可是如果你说都没有人喜欢我
，The problem isn't that nobody likes you, it's that you don't like you.
问题不是没有人喜欢你，问题是你都不喜欢你自己。
Have you ever met anybody for the first time?
你有没有碰过任何人？你有没有第一次碰过一个人的时候有这样的感觉过？
And you don't even know him.
你根本就不认识他哦。
And maybe you don't even have a conversation with him.
你甚至可能有跟他交谈。
But you immediately like them.
然后你就立刻当下就喜欢他。
Like you're like, I'd give him my wallet. I just trust that person.
你就觉得哇，好信任他，甚至把我的皮夹给他都没问题。
Haven't we all found people like that?
你有没有碰过这样的人？有没有这样的经验过
？You know why?
你知道为什么
？It's because they like themselves.
因为他们很爱他，喜欢他们自己。
And it makes you trust them.
就会让你信任他们。
It kind of, if you will, this is a metaphor.
当然，这是一个比喻啊。
But it kind of makes them smell good.
就会让他们感觉那个气味很好。
Have you ever went in a yard and you step in dog dew?
你有没有曾经去过那个走在那个草地上面，然后突然踩到狗屎
？But you don't know it.
然后你不知道。
And you come in the house.
然后你就进到家里面。
And your wife or your friend.
你的朋友就说
，What is that?
什么味道
？They didn't see anything.
他们没有看到任何东西。
They didn't see.The poo on your foot.
他没有看到你踩到的狗屎。
It's something smell.
就是有些很臭味啊。
There's something that happens in the spirit.
你知道在灵里面也会有些东西发生。
When you don't like you.
当你不喜欢你自己的时候，也会有一些东西发生。
There's a smell.
有一种味道。
There's a you can't see it.
是看不见的味道。
You can't explain it.
也没有办法解释的味道。
But you always experience it.
但是你总是会感觉到的味道。
When somebody doesn't like themselves.
当一个人不爱不喜欢他自己的时候
，they self-reject.
当他们自我拒绝的时候
，and when they do,
当他们自我拒绝的时候
，it's like being afraid, and like a dog can sense that you are afraid.
就好像你怕狗一样，那个狗总是知道你是怕它的
，and he will chase you.
然后狗就特别喜欢追那些怕狗的人。
When you reject you,
当你拒绝你自己
，it's like there's a smell on you.
在你身上就好像有那种。味道
And when you have you ever met someone?
你有没有碰过一些的人
Maybe they're beautiful.
可能很美
Or handsome.
很帅
Like they looks like everything's really great.
看起来好像一切都很美好
But when you meet them,
可是当你真的跟他们认识的时候
In your mind,
在你头脑里面在想
You don't like them.
你不喜欢他们呢
You don't even know why.
你也不知道为什么不喜欢他们
I'm being so judgmental.
我怎么那么论断人呢
What's wrong with me?
到底怎么了
What happened is they don't like themselves.
发生什么事是他们不爱他们自己。
When they get around you,
当他们在你旁边的时候
，something in the spirit goes.
在灵里面会有个这样的东西出现。
You won't like me. You won't like me.
你不喜欢我的。You won't like me. 你不会喜欢我的。你不会喜欢我的。
You won't like me.
你不会喜欢我的。
It's like a smell.
就好像一个味道一样。
It's like a signal.
好像是一个给别人一个讯号一样。
That you can't see.
是看不见的讯号。
But you can totally experience it.
可是你可以感受得到。
And I want to just say that.We need to learn how to love ourselves.
我们需要学会怎么样爱我们自己。
Sometimes we have to actually learn how to love ourselves.
有的时候我们需要学习怎么爱我们自己。
Sometimes it happens.
有的时候是这样发生的。
By someone believing in you.
有人真的相信你。
Before you believe in you.
在你还没有相信你自己之前。
I told you I had two stepfathers who didn't like me.
我说过，我有两个继父是不喜欢我的。
What time are we supposed to be done, sir?
Before seven.
Okay. I had two stepfathers who didn't like me.
我有两个继父不喜欢我。
But I had a grandfather who loved me.
但我有一个祖父是非常爱我的。
My grandfather.
我的祖父。
I have to give you a picture of my grandfather.
我要给你一个我祖父的一个形象啊。
My grandfather was he was like he wasn't fat.
我的祖父不是很胖。
But he was like a farmer.
但是他就像是一个农夫一样
He was kind of short,
他有点矮
but he was like stocky.
但是他就是比较那种厚重的
And he wore coveralls. You know what coveralls are?
Like 就是他穿的是那种连身的衣服你知道叫农夫连身的衣服
and he didn't wear any underwear.
但是他不穿内裤
And you would know.
你是知道他不是没有穿内裤。
He didn't button his coveralls.
因为他的那个连身裤哈，
My grandmother would always be mad at him. Say, button your overalls.
然后我的祖母总是跟他讲说，你可不可以
把你的 Put wear underwear.
你的连身的裤
Say, oh no, it climbs up my rear.
说你可不可以穿个内裤，要不然的话把你的连身裤扣好。
And then he had a gum disease.
然后他，你知道他的牙龈有点状况。
So they pulled all of his teeth out.
所以他们就把他的牙齿都全部都拔掉。
Except for his four eye teeth.
除了
his four eye teeth.
除了他的这个虎牙哈。
They left them in.
他就这边牙齿留在那边。
And then they made dentures around his eye teeth.
然后就在这四个牙齿旁边都做了假牙。
But he said that his dentures.
然后他说他的假牙。
That he said they hurt him.
他说他假牙会痛，所以。
So he would take them out and put them in his coveralls.
所以他就会把他假牙拿下来，就放在他的那个连身裤、连身衣的那个口袋里。
Just in case he needed them.
就是如果他需要牙齿，就拿出来。
Pop them right out so he can chew.
所以他可以放回去，然后再咬东西。
Then he put them back in his coveralls.
然后就放在他的连身那个口袋里面。
And then he would do this thing with his mouth.
然后他嘴巴会这样做。
He can't do it if you have teeth, but he suck his mouth.
他会这样子。因为你有牙齿的话很难做的。
And my grandfather didn't really walk.
我的祖父他平常走路的时候很奇怪。
He sort of waddled.
他不是走路，他是这样子，有点滑行的。
But he really loved me.
但他真的很爱我。
And I remember when I was a young boy, I was probably 10 years old.
我记得当我十岁的时候。
My grandfather used to go to the hardware store all the time. You guys even have hardware stores here?
我的祖父他都喜欢去那种什么特力屋那种店。
And he would always say, "You want to come with me?"
他总是问我说你要。
We lived right next to my grandfather when I was a little boy.
但我还小的时候，我就住在我祖父的旁边。
So my mother wasn't married at the time.
我的母亲那时候还没有嫁人。
And I would say, I'm gonna go with grandpa.
我就跟我妈妈说，我要跟阿公一起去。
And my grandfather would always buy me something at the hardware store.
所以我的祖父总会在那种特力屋的商店里面买一些东西给我。
So my mom would say,
我的妈会说
，Don't you ask your grandfather for anything.
你不要跟你阿公求叫他买任何东西给你，知道吗？
So then we leave.
然后我们就去。
We go to the hardware store.
就去到那种特定的地方。
And my grandfather would say, "Just go ahead and look around."
然后我的祖父就说，你去看看。
And when I'm done getting my stuff, I'll find you.
然后我去找到我要买的东西的时候，我会来找你。
So I'd look around.
我就随便看看，随便看看。
One day I was looking around.
有一天我在随便看看的时候。
I was looking at the hammers.
我就看到那个榔头啊。
I'm like, "Whoa, I'd like to have a hammer."
哇，我想要弄个榔头。
So my grandfather comes.
我的祖父来的时候。
And he goes,You want a hammer?
说你要个榔头吗
？No.
我说不要了。
Did your mother tell you not to ask for a hammer?
你妈妈是不是叫你不要求榔头
？Uh-huh.
我说对。
Buy a hammer.
买个榔头给你。
So I bought a hammer.
所以我就买了一个榔头。
And I bring it home.
我带回家。
And I go in.
我回到家里面。
Look, mom.
妈。
I got a hammer.
我有一个榔头哎。
I told you not to ask.
我告诉你不要跟他要东西。
He just bought it for me.
他自己买的。
So my mother would she worked during the day.
我的妈妈每白天都要上班。
So I was home like 2 hours by myself.
所以每一天至少两个小时是我自己在家里面。
And I said like we lived with my grandfather.
所以我们是跟我祖父住在一起。
So that day, you know, I started using my hammer.
那天我开始用我的榔头。
Hammering everything I can hammer.
所有可以用榔头用的东西我都开始。我的家里都在敲敲敲敲敲一直敲。
Well, the second day I ran out of things to hammer.
第二天我就已经没有东西可以敲了。
So I thought I'm going to build a go kart.
我说我要来盖一个那种小小的车子。
And I'm looking for wood to build a go kart.
所以我到我们的 garage 车库里面，我看到有没有木头可以把这个小车子做出来。
So I tear the siding off the side of the garage.
所以我就把那个我们的车库旁边那边东西拆下来。
To build a go kart.
要做一个我自己的小车子，木头小车子。
So I nail it all together.
我就把它所有的都钉好了。
With the siding, the wood from the side of the house.
就是我们的房子边的那个木头，把它拆下来，然后弄一个这个。
Sun shining through the garage.
现在是没有墙壁了。
As high as I can tear it off, I tear off.
只要我能够拔下来的，我都拔下来。所以那个阳光是直接照到我们车库里面。
I needed wheels.
那我需要轮子啊。
So I go in the garage. I'm looking for wheels.
我去到车库里面，我找轮子。
My grandfather's got a lawnmower.
哎，我的祖父他有一个。
So I take the wheels off the lawnmower.
除草机，我就把除草机上面的轮胎拿下来。
And I nail to the go kart.
然后我就把它钉在我的那个车子上面。
So my mom comes home.
当我妈回来的时候。
And I said.Mom, look.
我说妈，你来看。
I built a go kart.
我自己打造了一个小小的木头车。
Oh yeah, that's nice.
哎，看起来不错。
Where'd you get the wood?
木头哪里来的
？From the garage.
我说车库里。
sun shining through the side of the garage.
那个太阳是直接照进到我们的车库里。
Your grandfather's going to kill you.
你的爷祖，你阿公，
you understand me? Your grandfather's going to kill you.
你死定了哦。
I know. Where'd you get the wheels?
那这个轮胎哪里来的？
From the lawnmower?
就是除草机上面的轮胎。
You are dead.
你死定了。
Young man, do you hear me?
年轻人，告诉你。
When you, your grandfather gets home,
当你阿公回家的时候
you're gonna tell him what you did.
你要告诉他你做了什么事。
Okay. Oh. My grandfather comes home.
然后我的祖父回来。
In a black Ford, he had it my whole life.
然后他就是开了一个黑色的福特的车子。
Comes rolling in the driveway.
然后开到。
Gets out.
车道上面，然后下车。
How's your day?
他说你怎么啦？今天怎么样？还不错。
I built a go-kart.
我打造了一个这个木头的车。
Go-kart.
哦，我来看看。
Let's see it.
我们来看。
Oh, that's a nice go-kart.
这是一个很好的木头的。
Where'd you get the wood?
木头哪里来的？
From the garage.
车库。
My grandfather looks up.
我的祖父刚抬头看。
Sun shining through the side of the garage.
阳光照透我们的车库。
My mother's standing there. She has me by the neck.
我妈妈是这样掐着我的脖子。
She goes, tell your grandfather where you got the wood.
告诉你祖父，你的轮子哪里来的？
From the garage.
也是在车库。
He goes, oh, that's no problem. We'll just put some plywood on the side.
他说没有关系，我们只要把一些东西弄上去，再弄些木头。
Where'd you get the wheels?
那轮胎哪里来的？
From the lawnmower.
从那个除草机。
He goes, oh, come on, get in the truck. Let's get in the car. Let's go buy you some real wheels.
他说我们上车，我们去买真正的轮胎给你。
My mother's like, you are dead when you get home.
回来的时候在死定了。
He buys me wheels. He rebuilds my go kart.
他帮我买那个轮子，然后重新帮我把这个车子盖好。When
I was 15 years old,
当我十五岁的时候
，my grandfather bought a farm.
我的祖父 farm.
He bought a farm.
他买了一个农场。
And I would live with him in the summer.
所以我暑假的时候会去跟他一起住。
And I have 8 cousins that are all girls. I'm the only boy.
所以我有八个那个堂兄弟姐妹哦。只有姐妹啦，只有我是唯一的男生。
So my grandfather was not a Christian.
我的祖父他不是基督徒哦。
And everybody would come to the farm for Thanksgiving.
我们全家族都会在感恩节的时候来到他的农场。
So my grandfather has this old truck, big truck. You guys don't have big trucks here.
我的祖父他有一个非常大的卡车，我们台湾没有大卡车。
It's really old.
而且很老。
And we're on this big farm.
我们在一个很大的一个农场。
So all my 8 cousins,
所以我其他的八个堂兄堂姐妹，他们都来到这个农场。
And my uncles and aunts, you know, they're having a party. They're drinking a little too much.
那我所有的这些的叔叔伯伯阿姨，他们都在那边喝酒，有点喝太多了。
So my grandfather throws me the keys to the truck.
所以我的祖父就把
I'm 15.
我那时候十五岁，我祖父就把他的大卡车的那个钥匙丢给我。
Go have some fun.
他说你去开心一下。
So all these city girls.
所以这些城市的女生们
jump on the back of this big flatbed truck.
他们都跳到这个大卡车后面的那个地方。
And we go down the hill.
然后我们就开下山坡。
Where the orchard is.
就开到那一个树林当中。
And we're driving through the orchard.
我们就从那边都要开过去。
With them hanging on.
他们就在那边紧紧抓着。
As fast as the truck will go.
就是我是把它吹到那样子，很快。
Isn't very fast.
其实不是很快啊。
It's and dust is just covering the truck.
那你就知道这尘土就这样子。
Dust is flying.
然后那个尘土就非常。
And all of a sudden, there's mud.
突然有那种泥巴。
And we get stuck in the mud.
那我们就在泥巴中卡住了。
And the girls are like.
然后那些女生们。
Now we're stuck.
I said. 我们卡住了。
You must get off and push.
我说你们现在要下车来推车。
No, we're not pushing.
I'm like,
oh yeah, you have to get off and push.
你现在要下车推车。
No, no. I said, you have to get off and push, or we're going to stay in the mud.
我说你们要下来推车，不然我们就卡在这边。
So all these girls, teenagers.
所以这些都是你
知道，they get in the back of the truck.
他这些女生们都下车后来。
I rev the truck up.
我下面。
Let the clutch go.
然后我就让那个离合器放下。
Covers them with mud.
那他们全身都是泥巴。
And they're screaming like push.
我就说推。
And we get the truck out of the mud.
我们就从泥巴中出来。
And I go, get on.
我说赶快上车，赶快上车，赶快上车。
So they get on the truck.
他们就上车。
And we're following this dirt road.
我们就走这个泥巴的路。
The river's on this side.
那你知道这河流在这边，河在这边。
And there's a cliff on this side.
然后这边是一个山崖呀。
It's a very narrow road.
是很窄的一个路。
So I'm going as fast as I can go.
我就是很
快。Girls are hanging on the back. And I forget that the road is washed up.
我忘记了这个之前有下过雨，这个路是很滑的。
The road ends.
然后我忘记这个路就到了。
So all of a sudden, I look, And the river has washed the road out.
哦，那就是那个河流已经把这个路已经冲过。之前下雨的时候，所以路已经没有路了。我突然停下来。
I'm like, oh no.
我说 oh no.
We have to back up 2 miles.
我们要倒车2英里的地方。
On this narrow road.
在这个很窄很窄的路上面。
So one of my cousins is in the front seat.
我其中一个堂姐呢，她在，她也坐在前面。
Open the door.
我说你把那个门打开。
And look down.
要看一下。
And make sure we don't drive off the cliff.
你要确保我们这个不要掉到山崖下面。
She said, okay.
她说 okay.
So she opens the door, and I put it reverse.
我就把它打到
and I go on fast as I can go backwards.
我还是开得很快
All of a sudden, I hear a tree
有一个树
hits the door,
把那个门
and rips it off.
把那个门直接的把那个门拆掉
and it bends it right in half.
它就变成两面
and it's hanging by one hinge.
然后那个门已经就只是有一个东西还好像还在那边一样
My cousin goes.
我的堂姐说
Grandpa's gonna kill you.
阿公一定会要你死
Grandpa's gonna kill you.
你死定了
So I say, so we back all the way up.
然后我们就倒车
And we go back up to where the house is on top of the hill. And I say to the girls,
我就跟这些
Don't tell anybody.
不要跟任何人讲
We wrecked the truck.
我们把这个车子搞坏了
We didn't wreck the truck. You wrecked the truck.
他说不是我们把这个车撞坏是你把这个车撞坏了
They get off the truck.
他们一下车
They run in.
他们跑进去
Chris wrecked the truck.
Chris 把车撞坏了
My uncle comes out.
我的叔叔他们出来啊
One of his girls were on the back of the truck.
其中那个他的女儿在那个车子
He comes out. He looks.
他看
The door.
看那个门是这样的关
He looks at me.
他看着我
You could have killed those girls. You are in trouble. Do you understand me? You. Then here comes my grandfather.
然后他就说你哦，你这样子开车，他们可能会死，你知道吗？你完蛋了，你完蛋了。然后我的祖父就出来。
And he walks up.
他走过来。
And my uncle's yelling at me.
然后我的祖父在骂我。
And he winks at me. My grandfather winks at me.
然后我的祖父就跟我眨个眼。
Like I got this.
他说我来，我搞，我搞定。
And he goes.
他说。
What happened here?
啊，发生什么事啊
？Grandma was back in a tree.
然后我就很快的把这个故事讲。
My uncle staring at me.
我叔叔一直瞪着我。
My grandfather goes, oh.
我的祖父就说。
He goes, you know, I've been thinking about taking the doors off this truck anyway.
他说我其实一直在想把这个卡车的门拆掉。
It just takes way too much time to open and close these doors.
每次要开车开门跟关门花好多时间哦。
Take those doors off the truck.
把这个门拆了啦。
My uncle's like, you are dead.
我的叔叔说你死定了。
My grandfather bought me a motorcycle.
我的阿公买了一个摩托车给我。当我十五岁，他买一个摩托车给我。
And I got to and so I my grandfather would she'd go to work at a factory.
你知道我妈妈她去一个工厂上班。
And he leave me a list of chores.
我的阿公他去工厂上班，然后他给我一系列的很多的清单要做的东西。
That I had to do on the farm.
就是在农场当中我需要做的事。
And then when I was all done with the chores, then I could, you know, do whatever I wanted.
那只要把这些事情做好，我就可以做我任何我想做的事。
And my grandfather built me a treehouse.
那我的阿公他也帮我盖了一个树屋。
A really cool treehouse.
是真的很棒的一个树屋。
It had a bridge from the treehouse to the hill.
他从那个树屋还盖了一个就像是那种一座桥哦，出去到那个整个的山坡上面。
It had a toilet.
树屋里面还有厕所啊。
Yeah, you didn't want to be under when you flush, though.
对，可是那个马桶一冲下去的时候，你不要在那个树屋的下面，他就直接往下冲。
It was really cool.
很棒啊。
And I was not allowed to drive the tractor if he wasn't there. That was the rule.
那唯一的他给我的一个条件就是他如果不在现场，我不能够开那个很大的那种卡车。
So I got all my chores done.
所以我该做的事都做完。
And I go down, I'm just messing around in my treehouse.
我就在树屋里面那边玩耍。
And there's another tree that grew like this through my treehouse.
有另外一棵树，它就是进到我的树屋里面的那个样
子。So I thought I'm going to get a chain and tie it to my motorcycle and pull the tree out.
所以我就在想。我要用一个铁链把那个树干在我树屋里面的树干、哦、用摩托车把它拉出去我的树屋。
So I go up to the farm.
我就去到那个农场里面。
And I get a chain.
我就拿那种铁链。
And I get on my motorcycle.
我就在我的摩托车上。
And I drive down and I hook the chain to the tree.
我就把那个那个铁链绑在那个树上。
And I hook it to my the back of my motorcycle.
然后绑到我的那个摩托车。
And I back up.
我就
And I take off. And I fly over the handlebars.
然后我就飞出去。
And I fall into the dirt.
我就整个人摔倒在泥巴里面。
And I'm totally mad.
我好生气啊。
So I walk over the tree.
我就走过到那个树。
And I say, you have messed with the wrong person.
我说你真的是你搞错人了，我告诉你。
So I decide.
我就决定。
That I'm going to get a really long chain.
我要找拿一个很长的一条铁链。
Climb up at the top of the tree.
然后跑到最这个树上。
Tie the chain around the top of the tree.
爬到树的最高上面，然后把那个铁链绑在上面。
Get up more speed.
然后可以有更快的速度。
And snap it off.
然后把它弄断。
So I go up to the top of the where the farm is.
我就去到我们的农场里面。
And I get all the chain I can find.
我把所有可以找到的铁链都拿出来了。
Like from here to the doors.
所以就从这边到那个墙壁那边。
Like 150 feet of chain.
就是150尺。
And I got it wrapped around my neck.
然后我就把它弄。
And I'm going down the hill.
我就把它弄到我的脖子上面，绑在我的脖子上。
Like Rambo.
然后就像兰坡一样。
And I get to the tree.
到树的时候。
And I take the chain.
然后我就把。
And I climb the tree.
然后我就爬到那个树上面。
It takes me like 20 minutes to climb the tree with all this chain.
你知道，光是要爬树，因为那么多的那个铁链在我身上，就花了二十分钟。
And I tie the chain to the top of the tree.
然后我就把那个铁链绑到树的上面。
And I tie it to my motorcycle.
然后绑到我的摩托车上。
Now, if you think about it, the treehouse is right here.
你知道树屋在这边。
And there's a hill right here.
这边有一个山坡。
So I take my motorcycle and I pull it up the hill backwards.
所以我就把我的摩托车拉到山坡上面。
So that I can go down the hill.
所以我就可以冲下坡。
And get up speed.
有足够的速度。
Past the tree.
然后就走过那个，冲过那个树。
So I'll be in fourth gear.
所以我已经到打了四档了。
When I pass the tree.
当我冲过那个树的时候。
It'll break right off.
啊，那个树干就会断掉。
So I go all the way up the hill.
所以我就一直把车推到推摩托车。
Get on the motorcycle.
在摩托车上面。
And I start going, and I pass the tree, and the tree goes, and then I fly over the handlebars, like 50 feet, I land on my back, and all of a sudden, the tree goes, and the motorcycle flies through the air, and lands on the top of the hill.
然后它降落在那个山坡上。
I'm on my back watching the whole thing.
我就已经躺在地上，我在看它发生事。
So now I'm really mad.
我现在真的很生气了。
So I go get my grandfather's tractor.
我就把我祖父的那个 tractor， 就是那个大的卡车。
Which I'm not supposed to drive.
就是我不应该可以开的。
I know I should have just cut it down. I didn't think of it.
我其实用一个做电锯把它锯下来就好了嘛，我干嘛那么麻烦
？Never occurred to me.
可是我当时都没想到这个点。
I get the tractor.
我就把那个大卡车弄出来。
I get the chain.
然后把那个铁链。
I drive the tractor.
然后我就开那个车。
I'm so out of my mind mad.
我已经气到一个地步。
Covered in dirt.
啊，全身都是泥巴。
My teeth are covered in dirt.
然后我的牙齿都有泥巴。
I drive down. I put the forks around the tree.
然后我就开始。开到那个车树旁边。
I wrapped a chain around the forks and the tree.
我把那个整个的车子的后面跟那个树干连在一起。
I rev the motor.
然后我就把那个马达引擎开得很快。
I pull the lever. And the forks go oh and bends the forks.
然后他就把那个
straight down.
哦，他其实是那个农作物弄农作物的那个车子，他整个前面的东西就整个的坏掉了。
Oh oh. I try to pull him up.
我才把他们把拉回来，拉不回来。
I drive the tractor back up the hill.
我再把那个车子开到回到山上。
I put it in the garage.
把它放到车库里面。
My grandfather comes.
我的祖父回来了。
In his old Ford, black Ford he had my whole life.
他就开着那个黑色的福特的车子。
He drives in.
开进来。
He gets out of his car.
车子出来。
How was your day?
啊，你今天怎么了？
Okay.
还好。
Did you get all your chores done?
该做的事都做完吗？
哦吼。Are you okay?
你还好吧？
哦。
不太好。
What's wrong?
怎么了？
哦 ，Follow me.
跟着我来。
I take him in the shop.
我带他去到那个车库里。
Grandfather.
我的祖父。
the tractors.
在那个，他的那个完全被已经折变成这个样子。
What happened?
怎么了？
My grandfather said.
我的祖父说。
My grandfather looks at me and he goes.
我的祖父说。
I've been wanting to teach you how to use the torches.
我一直要教你怎么样使用那个东西，那个那种炼铁的，让铁可以软下来的东西很久了。
This will be a really good lesson.
所以这是一个很好的学习的经验。
I'm glad you did this.
我很开心你做这件事情。
Grandfather's gonna kill you.
阿公会教训你。
You know, my grandfather didn't know the Lord.
我的阿公不认识主。
Till the year before he died.
在他直到他要死之前的那一年。
But it's funny that the Lord used him to demonstrate the love of God.
但是很有趣的是，神却使用他向我来彰显天父的爱。
To a very broken young man.
对于一个很破碎的年轻人来
讲，who no one else loved.
他没有任何人爱我，你知道吗？
And I believe that my grandfather's love for me.
我相信我祖父对我的爱。
Was the reason I hungered for the love of the Father.
也是我为什么那么渴慕神的爱，天父的爱的原因。
Because he loved me.
因为他爱我。
When I was a mess.
当我还是很糟糕的状态当中，他就爱我。
And he loved me.
他爱我。
Even when I messed up.
在我犯的所有的错误当中，他仍然继续爱我。
And I want to finish tonight by saying,
我今天晚上要结束之前，我要这样说。
Ephesians 3 says that I would that you would know the love of God.
以弗所书第三章告诉我们说，我渴望你认识神的爱。
That surpasses understanding.
是超越人所能够测度的。
How do I know something that can't be understood?
我怎么样能够知道一个东西是我没有办法用理性去衡量理
解的？The Greek word there is.
希腊文在这边说的是什
么？
是透过你的经历真正尝到。
What you couldn't know by understanding.
就是你能够尝到你的理性不能够测度的那个爱。
And I want to pray for you all.
今天我想为你们每一个人祷告。
That you would experience a love you can't explain.
让你可以经历一个爱是你没有办法用理由用理性去了解的。
Because your heart will take you places your head can't go.
因为你的心会带你去一些的地方是你的理性还不明白的。
Would you stand, please?
我们从位上站起来。
Would you put your hand on your heart, please?
可不可以把你的手放在你的心上？
Sometimes we read 1 Corinthians 13.
有的时候我们读到哥林多前书第十三章，
about love.
就是那个爱的真谛的那一章。
And we're like, I do all that.I do all those things.
我们可能会说，我做这些所有的东西。
When I still haven't experienced anything.
可是我还是没有经历到这份爱啊。
And I want to pray tonight, and my prayer for you tonight.
我今天要为你做的祷告是这个。
And my prayer for you tonight.
我今天要为你做的祷告很简单。
Is that what happened to me on the night that Eli loved me?
就是那天晚上。当伊莱爱我的时候，我所经历到的。
On the night that I laid in bed,
那天晚上我躺在床上。
And God said,
然后神说
，Here's the challenge. You don't love you.
你的挑战
$30,000 worth.
是你不够爱你自己，像是百万一
样的爱你。And the rest of that story,
后来的故事是
，Is that the Lord spent a year loving on me.
主花了一年的时间让我经历好好的经历到他的爱
with extreme love.
是那一种挥霍的爱
and he was loving the sickness out of me.
他把那一个我内心深处的疾病借着他的爱来医治来恢复
the rejection of a lost father and three and two stepfathers who didn't like me.
当我的自己的生父他因着死离开我还有两个继父的拒绝我得到医治
He was loving that out of me.
他把那一个破碎那一个空缺满足了
And I believe that the Lord wants to love you the same way.
我相信主今天晚上要用同样的方式来爱你
Not in your head.
不是在你的头脑里面。
I know Jesus loves me.
我知道耶稣爱我。
I knew Jesus loved me in my head.
我的头脑都知道耶稣爱我。
That wasn't the problem.
这不是头脑知道的知识，不是问题。
My problem is, the problem was my heart didn't know it.
可是问题是我的心并不知道他真实爱我。
So I pray right now.
所以我现在为你祷告。
That you would have an encounter with the Lord.
你要有一个真实的遇见主的经历。
Tonight.
今天。
Or in the next 7 days.
或在未来的七天当中。
In which you would experience the love of God that you can't explain.
你要真实经历到神的爱是你没有办法用理性来解释的。
I pray for that right now.
我现在就为你做这个祷告。
And Lord, we break the spirit of rejection off of people.
神，我们破除一切被拒绝的灵在人的身上。
Lord, we break the spirit of hatred off of people.
父神，我们破除在人身上的那个憎恨。
Lord, we break the spirit of suicide and self-destruction off of people.
我们破除那个自我毁灭、自杀的灵在人的生命里面。
Lord, we cancel shame's assignment over people.
我们破除一切从羞耻来要带给我们的这个愧疚。
And we release right now.
我们释放。
The love of God.
父神的爱。
That's wide.
那个长。
Deep.
阔。
And long.
高。
We just release that love.
神的爱就在我们中间。
Over every single person.
降临到每一个人的身上。
And Lord, I pray.
主，我向你来祷告。
That you would kiss each person in here.
你会要亲吻我们在座的每一个人
into a new revelation
进入到一个新的启示的里面
of how much you love them
就是你有多爱他们
Lord, you're not like my uncle who was angry with me
你不像我的叔叔一样就是一直在生我的气
You're like my grandfather
你就像我的阿公一样
who I couldn't do anything wrong
就是在他眼中我没有做任何的错
Lord, I pray that you would show everyone in here
主我祷告你要向每一个人显现
you are not angry with them.
就是你没有在生他们的气
you are not mad at them.
你没有在生他们的气
you are passionately in love with them.
你热切地爱着他们
and I bless them.
我祝福他们
in Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣的名
and I want you to say,
我要你这样说
I receive it for myself.
我领受神的爱
I receive it. I receive it for my family.
我为我的家人领受这份爱
I receive it for my children.
我为我的孩子们领受这份爱。
I receive it for my grandchildren.
我为我的孙子们领受这份爱。
I receive your love.
我领受你的爱。
For my legacy.
为了我的子子孙孙。
May my legacy.
让我的后代。
Be marked by your love.
是有你的爱的印记在他们的生命里面
Forever
永永远远
Amen God bless you Thank you so very much
神祝福大家感谢大家、
Amen. 我们再一次的谢谢 Chris 牧师跟训正牧师的翻译好不好转向你左右两边的告诉他说天父对你的爱是一个挥霍的爱